some people, they just, in the back of their head, it's just some stupid kid painting on a wall. It has nothing to do with that. I don't frown upon it. I'm sure if I was a business owner, I probably wouldn't like it. Old people tend to not like it as much, but you gotta respect for what it is. It's definitely art. Graffiti art is definitely an underground, raw form of art, for sure. I mean, like, everyone's seen the spray paintings on walls, buildings, under bridges. Everyone's seen it. A lot of times, you'll sit there on a piece of paper in your home and get your work all set out, your name, what you're going to do, and then you'll take it to the streets. Or you can just go out there and just bomb, you know? It's all art. I mean, go look at the characters and stuff they have. It's not just words all the time. There'll be, you know, dope characters and little cartoons and stuff. There's some pretty amazing stuff people can do with spray paint. You'll be surprised. Out there, that's all they do. You know, you got a pen in your pocket, and every time you see something, you write up your name. Everyone sees it. You put up stickers. You know, go out at night. You know, just whatever you're feeling. It's just all on you. It's creativity. Whatever you want to do. That's half the fun also. There's definitely like crews, you'll definitely see their name up below the tag, like, you know, whatever their crew name is, and there's definitely rival gangs out there that they want to come up and cover up your stuff, and then you'll bomb over theirs. It's like a little war. It's definitely rivalries, but it's half the fun. It's way thought out. People just like look at it and be like, oh, it's just some spray painting. But it's not like we're going and putting your name Tom up there or something. That's stupid. Definitely thought out. Most people don't even realize how big of a scene it really has become. There's an underground scene. There's whole stores and websites and magazines just totally dedicated to it. A lot of people wouldn't realize because they don't involve themselves in it, but there's a lot of good friends and a lot of stuff to be, a lot of positive stuff comes out of it too. It's just not this negative thing like people think. Relatively new, like people have been like mixing paints also, so you get two colors and you're like, oh, I bet these two colors will make a dope color, and then you mix your own, mix and match. It's like you can take two cans of spray paint, empty one of them about halfway, freeze it, and then take another can that you're gonna mix with it, put that in boiling water and get it all hot so its pressure's really high. Then you have like a twin tip, stick them together, press both nozzles down, the hot one transfers into the frozen one because the frozen paint's gonna stay in the can, and then you just wait till it thaws and mix that can up, the frozen one, with the both paints in it, and voila, you got a brand new color. It's pretty awesome. About the thrill, definitely gives you some adrenaline rush. I mean, it's like skateboarding or something. There are plenty of places designated to skate, but the nature of the sport just drives skateboarders to go into the street, you know, create something new, make it cool. You know, it's all in your head, it's all creativity. And like, you know you're not wanted there, but you don't care. That's also why it's dope. I mean, it's what it is. Big time, you know, you'll put your piece on a train, and then wherever that goes, people are gonna see that, and, you know, vice versa, you're gonna see stuff that comes from all over the states. And Canada's got a big scene for sure. I mean, it's everywhere, for sure. Just research a little bit, you'll find a lot.